and a lot of support team members. Thank you, everybody. So I think today it will be a nice presentation and we can learn a lot of things from Mohammad Nazir Hossain on biotechnology, marine biotechnology. But I have another defense session is going on in Stanford University Environmental Science. So I just stop there and just for a few minutes I can join with you. And then later, I'm sorry for that. Thank you, thank you. Because I'm very eager to know from the keynote speaker about the marine biology, biotechnology, because it is a vast field and we have a lot of things to do. And this era is a biotechnological era. So we will learn from him, we'll listen from him. So thank you.
Thank you so much, Kamal.
Thank you, respected Dr. Gulshan Lokina, madam.
I think we can start, isn't it?
Yes, madam.
Welcome, everyone. Today's webinar on leadership in marine technology, engineering and science. This is one UN Ocean Decade endorsed event, which is mainly focusing on marine biotechnology, Bangladesh perspective. Malia, next slide, please. Okay, today's program is scheduled in such a way. First is welcome speech, and then our NOAMI brief introduction and keynote presenter introduction will be given by the Malia. And keynote presentations, and then next our one question answer session, which will be supported by the NOAMI support team. And finally, guest of honor is please. Our today's program guest of honor is Professor Dr. Gulshan Lotfia, madam. And finally, vote of thanks. Next slide, please. Okay. Many of we know that UN Ocean Decade is declared by the UN. It is 2021 to 2030. This is one of the very important initiative. The motto is the science we need for the ocean we want. And next. UNESCO IOC endorsed UN Ocean Decade event, which is co-organizing by the Marine Technological Society, India section, collaboration with the NOAMI. Actually, it targeted mainly the female researchers, female students, along with the school, college, and university researchers, and technology-friendly students and professionals. This is one of the what is called endorsed event, which is targeted one event on 14 September. It will be occurred at 6:30 Bangladesh time. End of the today's lecture, I will researcher Maliha will declare about it. So in that session, there is the three main keynote speakers are there. Very nicely that all the three speakers are very prominent. One is the president of World Maritime University. Another is the president of the Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers. And another is the president of Marine Technological Society. All are female. So this is one of the great inspiration for the all marine researchers. And next. Malia, next please. So now I would like to request Maliha Malek to give a brief introduction of NOAMI and introduce our today's keynote speaker, Professor Dr. Nazir sir. Please, Maliha.
Yes, thank you, sir. Mohan Kumar Das, which is the Executive Director of National Oceanography and Maritime Institute.
Ami welcome. Ami Arakta.
Shimada.
Malia, continue, please.
So we'd like to thank National Oceanography and Maritime Institute for organizing today's webinar. And first, we those participants. The founder chairman of the National Oceanography and Maritime Institute started its journey. It started its journey in 1978, and the founder chairman is Rear Admiral Musharraf Hossain Khan, who was the chief of the Bangladesh Navy. During his tenure, Sheikh Mujibur Rahman commissioned the Bangladesh Navy's largest training base, And he's one of the pioneers who established all marine science and oceanography related department, education institute, research institute, academic institution all over the Bangladesh. And the activities of NOAMI is very dominant in the oceanographic field. NOAMI is organizing conference training session to promote ocean science. And since 2001, NOAMI is annually conducting a training session, namely Oceanography Application and Principle for the professional and researcher students. Since 1984, NOAMI is publishing its journal, and very soon we will going to publish our 37th volume. Now it's in the review process. And we are very lucky to have Professor Gulshanara Latifa Madam, which is the Vice Chairman of NOAMI, also today's guest of honor. And in our journal panel, we have two international advisors from India and USA. And we are also honored to have Dr. Mohammad Nazir Hussain as our keynote speaker of today's event, which is one of the dominant editorial members for the journal. It's the journal of the NOAMI. And on right now, NOAMI is conducting a training session, namely data science and machine learning with Python. And these are the prominent topics which we are learned from this training. And the upcoming training session, which is 18 training course, Oceanography Principle and Application, will conduct in January 2020. And in this page, in our Facebook page, you can see the review of the participants about our training. These are the pictures by conducting the training. And now I'd like to introduce our keynote speaker, Dr. Mohammad Nazir Hussain, who is Associate Professor of the Department of Genetic Engineering and Biotechnology at the University of Sheikh Mujibur Maritime University. And research interest of Professor is Biotechnology, Molecular Biology, and Genetic Engineering. And research interests are very versatile. He is conducting research in different fields, such as damage recovery of human fibroblast involvement G protein in aging. And these are the noteworthy works of professor. And also our professor has 32 publications, 31 patents, and 2 books which are available in Amazon. Now I'd like to invite our professor to start his speech. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so
Welcome,
much.
Welcome, sir, please.
Thank you so much, it's my honor to be here. So I guess all of you are not so tired. So it's 7:40. So maybe I will take 25 minutes or 30 minutes to finish my presentation. So I can see 37 participants here. So let me share my screen. So I hope all of you can see my screen. Can you?
Yes, sir. It is all right.
Okay. Thank you so much. So, okay. Biotechnology, marine biotechnology. Let's talk about it. First, let's have a look at Bangladesh, a tiny piece of land between India, surrounded by India, we can say. So three side boundaries covered by India, and one side is the Bay of Bengal. And after the historic win, maritime win, the boundary mitigation with India and Burma, we have almost 200,000 square kilometers of land, sea, you can say, and which is 1.4 times than the land area. So our land area is so small. So there are almost 220 or 30 countries in the world, And as per the land area, our country stands 92nd position, which is fairly low. But if you think about the people, number of people living in this country, you'll be amazed. We are eighth, I repeat. So many people living in this small country. So now the corona is over. Now you can see what's happening in Dhaka city. So my university is not so far from my house. If I walk, it takes 30 minutes. If I use my car, it takes 45 minutes. That's the actual scenario. So you can imagine so many people are living on a tiny piece of land. Okay, so that's, but as I said, now we have a huge maritime area, so we can utilize this maritime area. Let's have a look at what is biotechnology. Lots of talk about biotechnology. Even small kids nowadays are talking about biotechnology. So many movies are coming out, Hollywood movies, Bollywood movies, and they are doing some cloning. So biotechnology are involved here. So now this is a buzzword. So everybody seems to know about biotechnology. So do you know that biotechnology is not so new? In fact, it's thousands of years old, I repeat. So as you know, we eat yogurt, right? Yogurt, we make bread. So that is also biotechnology. That's thousands of years old. So anything modified, utilized by the biological system, you can call it biotechnology. But nowadays, the modern biotechnology, you can say, that is also genetic manipulation, we say. Genetic manipulation. So, you know, the Dolly Polly, so many goats or other animals are cloned. Actually, this started in 1960s when Watson Crick just invented or discovered our genetic material, the DNA, the structure of DNA. So many interesting things are going on nowadays about biotechnology. But there are so many, as I said, so many hands of biotechnology. There are green biotechnology, blue biotechnology. That is, blue biotechnology actually means marine biotechnology. Okay, there is yellow biotechnology, there is brown biotechnology, dark biotechnology, purple, white, gold, name it. So many areas of biotechnology. But now we are much more concerned about marine biotechnology. Why? As I mentioned earlier, our land area is so small, but we are very productive. The number of population is huge. Even we cannot scratch our own hand in the bus, you may scratch somebody's hand. Let's see, what is marine biotechnology? As I said earlier, marine biotechnology uses marine organisms. But there are some issues, actually. So think about the land. So land is overexploited, and now we don't have anything. So we destroyed the forest. We destroyed the habitat of other animals. So if we do the same to the ocean, or to the Bay of Bengal, then what will happen? Same thing will go on, right? We'll destroy the habitat, everything. So we have to be concerned from the beginning. This marine biotechnology or blue biotechnology, so uses marine resources or marine organisms to develop a new biotechnological gain for the human beings. Okay, not only for human beings, actually for animals also. So these are some areas of actually biotechnology, medicinal sector, renewable energy, coastal tourism, aquaculture, mineral. These actually also involve in biotechnology, but not main in biotechnology. Main in biotechnology actually will go dig deeper, and then we'll see. These are the sectors in main in biotechnology, or we can say the blue biotechnology. So as I said, so many things are involved here and so much potential. Actually, from ancient time, if you look at the history of Greek people, they are using marine organisms to prepare medicine from ancient times. Even in Indian subcontinent for thousands of years, you know, Ayurveda, the science of life, that also describes the use of marine organisms to produce some sort of drugs. So how we can use this marine biotechnology or blue biotechnology for inventing or discovering or making new products? How we do it? These are this is actually one of the flowchart. This is for students, actually. That's just to let them know how we do it or how the scientists do this. First, we collect the samples. Then we investigate some biological or pharmacological efficacy of the crude extract, and then some chromatographic analysis. Then identify the lead compound, actually, we say. Then structural determination, then synthesis. And this is how actually it goes on. As you know, that blue biotechnology uses sponges, marine algae, or marine endophytes, the bacteria living in the ocean. Do you know that you talk about biodiversity of the land, but if you know the biodiversity of the ocean, you'll be much more surprised. Even one teaspoonful of water has more biodiversity than hectares of land. So you can imagine how potential it could be. The global biotechnological market actually is growing day by day. It's growing. There are so many companies, but as you know, always North America, Americans are always ahead of time. They are using this blue biotechnology from very beginning and try to be dominant in these sectors. And they are trying to rule this main biotechnology sector. And after that, Europe and then Asia Pacific and rest of the world is very low. And China and Japan actually now trying to catch them. And we know there are so many organisms living in the marine environment, but which organisms can we use? So there are vertebrates, invertebrates, that means fishes, mollusks, shells, seaweeds, sponges, marine microbes, so many things are there. We can use actually all of them for our gain. So we can develop pharmaceuticals, we can develop cosmetics, so many things. Nowadays, most famous cosmetics are actually made from these marine products. So if we cross-link this marine biotechnology with other sectors, we can see these are all interrelated. This marine biotechnology is connected to oncology, that means cancer research, immunology, tissue engineering, aquaculture, environment technology, tourism, shipbuilding. Everything is connected with this marine biotechnology. There are so many prospective areas on marine biotechnology. You name it: food, energy, human health, well-being, environment, life science, for industry. So many new kinds of foods are being prepared from marine organisms. It will be amassed. We actually, I'm sorry to say, we people only can cook rice and curry and some other salted vegetables. That's all. But if you just step outside Bangladesh, you'll be surprised to see they eat so many marine organisms. Suppose Malaya is living in France. She knows that food, they do research with food, and all of this food value is determined and how they have to serve, and most of them come from the marine habitat. But in Bangladesh, we consider our Bay of Bengal as a gold mine, but we cannot dig it out. But our neighboring countries capturing all of our fishes, all of our marine organisms, and we are blaming them, but we cannot do anything by ourselves. That's our problem, actually. This situation must change. Let's see what's going on, this marine biotechnology in European Union. So as I said, North America is the leader and followed by EU, but they are not far behind. They are also doing research on human health using marine biotechnological product. They are developing cosmetic compounds, industrial products, food supplements. That's if you step outside Bangladesh, you will find the doctor, they prescribe less medication, but more of food supplement. But in Bangladesh, we eat more, or we take more medicine than rice sometimes. Just look at the elderly people in Bangladesh. They take so many tablets, capsules in a day. It seems like they are having their whole energy from that medication. And our doctors love to prescribe at least 10 or 20 tablets per day for elderly people, even if somebody is suffering from diabetes or hypertension. That is usual for Bangladesh nowadays. So, as you know, our country is not self-sufficient in food. Sometimes we need to import food from other countries. But there is a revolution in fish and aquaculture, actually, I might say. Now, Bangladesh is number 4 in fish production all over the world. That is actually, a huge gain for Bangladesh with this lot of people and small piece of land. But look at other countries, what they did. We have shrimp, and we do have shrimp culture in our southern district. But what's happening? The unscrupulous businessmen putting jelly inside the shrimp, making them, little bit heavy so that they can gain, get some money. This unscrupulous businessman actually destroying the whole reputation of the country. But look at other countries. If you just go to Thailand, Myanmar, or Malaysia, you will see how they domesticated the shrimp culture, crab culture, sea cucumber, lobster. They have big farms, and with the help of biotechnology, actually, they developed more profitable species, we can say, more profitable species. So in that sense, we are actually lagging behind. So we talked about, for the last few minutes, we were talking about the biotechnology, how we can use. And let's see, so many sectors, suppose health, pharmaceuticals. In last 10 years, most anti-cancer drugs actually came from marine biotechnology. So biomaterials, bioadhesive, wound dressing, dental biomaterials, all these are coming from now marine sources. Tissue regeneration. Do you know that some of the jellyfish, they don't die. If you cut them into small pieces, those small pieces will eventually regenerate into small jellyfish. So that means, no, we cannot say that we have deciphered the mysteries of life. Actually, those jellyfish are a little bit different, and but they have the potential to develop or to cure our wounds, because they have regeneration capacity. And for females, cosmetics are very important. You know, Botox and some other cosmetics. And most of the cosmetics, it's very, very expensive one, are coming from these marine sources. Even when I was in Japan, I was the consultant of Sony CP, and I developed several cosmetics from them from marine resources. So from algal extract and from other species, I don't want to say the names because those are patent pending. And in Bangladesh, you know, do you know the malnutrition condition in Bangladesh? We are also are not so good condition, not in good condition actually. Bangladesh is lagging behind from other countries in terms of nutritional status. So to improve the nutritional status, we can utilize marine resources, we can develop nutraceuticals, we can develop some functional foods. Actually, if we build up some habit of eating marine sources, then we can solve this nutritional problem. And also energy, renewable energy can be, we can get from marine sources. Then we have biosensors. These are very interesting, you know, biosensors. You can check the pollution status of Bay of Bengal. You can sense many things using the biosensor. Even, do you know that when we do recombinant DNA technology, when we introduce genes to other animals or organisms, we use some reporter genes. Those are also biosensors. And those reporter genes also came from these marine resources. And we talked about aquaculture. This aquaculture is developing of fish or other resources into higher order so that we can get much more from them. Then bioremediation, pollution, biosensing, antifouling, bioadhesive, all of things, these things you can get from this marine resources. Okay. So these are some products actually now totally isolated and commercially used by various pharmaceuticals and various cosmetic industries. You can see so many things have been developed. So let's see the global scenario of blue biotechnology from 2019 and what would be in 2026. So always you can see North America, this is North America. Okay, but in 2026, the prediction, as per prediction, so this one is Asia Pacific. This one is almost catching up with North America in terms of marine biotechnology. So we should also catch up. So the growth of biotechnology, marine biotechnology, it's huge. The annual growth is almost, this is the data of 2019. So 2020, we are affected by COVID. So the data is, we are still gaining. So as per this data, the average growth is 5.98%. That is huge. And incremental growth we can see is $1.77 billion. That's actually huge. So there are some drivers of this blue biotechnology market. There are some trends, some regional segmented analysis are there. So now the trend is actually changing to some extent. As you can see, we said we were suffering from COVID for the last 1.5 years, but still the growth, you can see the growth here, 5.49%. The growth, that is huge, right? even though we had COVID, still we had the incremental growth of about $2.5 billion. That's huge. Other industries actually didn't grow that much. So actually what's going on in other countries, especially Africa. Africa, they are also catching up with the blue biotechnology, but they are using for it biofuels. Central and North America, they are for biodiversity, bioremediation, drug discovery. North America, they are actually pioneer. Canada, they're salmon and shellfish, they're pioneer products. India, our neighboring country, they are also using it for human health, for pharmaceuticals, foods, feeds, and cosmetics. Korea, they are catching up with the United States, I must say. Israel is also catching up with other countries. Turkey, they are also not behind, far behind. New Zealand, they are also doing high-tech research on biotechnology. So actually, you can utilize this blue biotechnology for our sustainable development. But what's going on in Bangladesh? Actually, as I said, our land area is only 148,000 square kilometers, but the sea area is almost 200,000 kilometers, which is 1.4 times. And every 7 new faces, about enough, 7 new faces every minute. Every minute we have to see 7 new faces. Can you imagine how productive we are? What's gonna happen after 20 years? I'll be there, you'll be there. So you let me know how many people will be in Bangladesh after 20 years. So how we can cope up this huge population? That's a big question, actually, $1 million question. So Bangladesh, we love to eat rice only. Do you know that? After Laos, Laos is a very poor country. They eat almost 500 grams of rice per day, but we are not far behind. We are almost the same. But what's happening about protein? We are consuming less fish, less protein. That's not good for the overall health of the country. Suppose, on the other hand, the Japanese people, they eat seaweeds or marine algae 25%, 21% in every meal. But in Bangladesh, we never eat any seaweeds. Only some tribal people eat some seaweeds, actually, that is negligible. Medicinal sector, almost 70% of the village people still depending on traditional medicine. But we can use this marine biotechnology, marine resources to develop new drugs, medicine, cosmetics, nutraceuticals, everything. But we don't do that. And I'm saying from the beginning that we have huge population, so controlling the environment actually very difficult nowadays. My wife is now posted to the Ministry of Environment, and she is in charge of the desk in our natural resource management. So we always talk about what's going on the natural resources and how they can control. She is in Environmental Ministry now. So it's very challenging nowadays. Nowadays, you have to set up the boundary, what to do, what not to do. But to meet the needs of the population, maybe sometimes you have to take some decision which may go against the environmental laws. Suppose if you need food now, maybe you have to do overfishing or you have to destroy their habitat, something like that. So it actually depends on the government and the situation of the country, and many other things are involved here. But as you know, this marine biotechnology, we can develop new things. Suppose oil spillage from the tankers, from the ships, these are a very big problem nowadays. Sometimes oil spillage, the oil flows all over the sea, and the bottom of the sea, there are so many habitats, and those are totally destroyed because of this oil spillage. But now, we have discovered some bacteria from marine resources, actually, those can eat up all the oil. So nowadays, you can control this oil spillage using the bacteria. So, and the biosensor there, so you can sense what's going on in the ocean, in the seas, using the marine organisms. So we still have hope. When we talk about marine biotechnology in Bangladesh, actually, we only talk about these seaweeds. The British people ruled us for 200 years, and they used some wrong words to describe some species, and we follow them. These are marine algae, actually, but we call it seaweeds. That's a popular term. And there are 193 seaweed species in Bangladesh as total, and so far discovered, and 94 genera belonging to three major divisions.
স্যার আপনি কি আমাদেরকে শুনতে পাচ্ছেন? হ্যালো, আই থিঙ্ক সাম নেটওয়ার্ক ইস্যু, উই জাস্ট নিড টু ওয়েট, আই এম ট্রাইং টু কমিউনিকেট। Okay, sir is joining again soon. Due to network connectivity, sir is disconnected. Sir will join soon. Muslimuddin sir, how are you?
এই তো আলহামদুলিল্লাহ আছি ভালো, থ্যাংক ইউ। আমি মানে কি বলবো, ব্যস্ততার কারণে আপনার সাথে কমিউনিকেশন করতে পারছি না। যেমন এই 8:30 আবার একটা ক্লাসে কানেক্ট হয়ে যাব, একটু সময় পেয়েছি আধা ঘন্টা, এই জন্য একটু এনজয় করতেছি আর কি।
রাইট টাইম, একজ্যাক্টলি রাইট টাইম। মানে আমাদের প্রোগ্রাম 8:30 মধ্যে শেষ হয়ে যাবে আশা করি। আমাদের আবার ট্রেনিং ক্লাস তো 8:30।
জি জি, তো
হ্যাঁ স্যার জয়েন করেছেন।
সরি আই গট ডিসকানেক্টেড, আই এম সো সরি।
ইটস অল রাইট স্যার,
সি ওয়ার ইজ মাই প্রেজেন্টেশন। So can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Perfect. All right.
Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. It is all right. We can see your slide and you are loud and clear. Sir, it is all right, sir. Hello. Sir, আমরা শুনতে পাচ্ছি আপনাকে।
আপনাকে তো শোনা যাচ্ছে না আপনাদের কালকে।
আচ্ছা আপনি তাহলে শেষ করেন, কন্টিনিউ করেন, তারপর আবার সাউন্ড চেক করে নিয়েন।
আচ্ছা আচ্ছা।
আমরা শুনতে পাচ্ছি ওকে স্যার
Sorry, some problem with BDRAM. So sometimes it happens. I'm sorry about that. So we only talk about the seaweeds and we collect the seaweeds from these areas of St. Martin Island or from the Bay of Bengal. And there are some seaweed facilities we have developed so far for this using the seaweeds. And these are some foods actually developed by developed from seaweeds and some cosmetics also. Foods and cosmetic noodles developed from seaweeds. And these are commercially imported seaweeds. And these seaweeds have enormous power. It can serve a source of food, source of income and livelihoods, export earning, we can say, additives, emulsifier, nutraceuticals, medicine. So many things actually we can do using the seaweeds. But actually it's not so easy. Systematic investigation is necessary and government support, governmental support is also necessary. So, and we need money, huge money and good brain and also dedication. Without dedication, actually, we cannot develop anything. That's why we always start a project and then we give up after a few months or nothing will get from here. That is the actual scenario, what's going on. So,
hello. I think again network issue.
So why we cannot develop this biotechnology, main biotechnology? So first thing is lack of technology, socioeconomic constraint, and shortage of skilled manpower. That is our problem actually. From the very beginning, we're suffering this sort of problem. And this large-scale commercial seaweed culture is required. Experienced manpower, we don't have that. And we don't know how important this seaweed or marine biotechnology is. Marine biotechnology is not only for seaweed, there are also some other marine organisms involved. So this is my lab, we are collecting seaweeds this year actually in the, maybe March, yeah, March. We went to St. Martin Island to collect the seaweeds and to investigate what sort of bioactive compounds are there. So hopefully we'll try to develop some new things, but we want to move ahead all together, not sporadic. We want cooperative and you can see so many kinds of seaweeds. So as the BD rain is, I don't know, something is wrong with the BD rain. So I think I must end here. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir, for your excellent and very time demanding presentation. It's really
so can you hear me? I cannot hear any of you.
Yes, sir, we can hear you. Can you hear us, sir?
Sir, I think there's some audio problem with the Nazim,
okay.
Nazir, sir.
Okay, I just talked with him over phone. So the presentation is very nice and it is really excellent one. Now we will take the questions. Just before that, I'll talk.
আমি আপনাদের কাউকে শুনতে পাচ্ছি না।
হ্যাঁ, স্যার একটা কাজ করি তাহলে।
ওই হ্যাঁ, এখন শুনতে পাচ্ছি। হ্যাঁ, এখন আসছে।
Okay, good, good. এখন শুনতে পাচ্ছেন স্যার? Thank you. Okay, fine. So now I would like to request our support team member, Nadim Mahmood. He's actually the one of the ambassador of this Marine Technology Society and Ocean Endorsed Program. He's working with, along with the Maliha Malek. And we have very good number of support team member. So many of them already been joined. So I request Nadim, are you there? Mr. Nadim?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now you just request the participant who already raised some questions. First question is from Nalia M. Malek. So you just request her to ask the question directly to sir. Okay, Nadim, please.
Sir, I don't get it. What you're trying to...
Okay, Nadim. Okay, I can just support you. Ms. Nalia M. Malek, are you there? So you can ask the question directly to sir. If you are not... Okay, I think you are there. Hello.
Hello,
yeah.
It's Naila, actually. My question was, what will be the suggestions for future biotechnologists who are looking forward to work in the marine biotechnology?
Sir, can you hear the question?
I think I got it. So maybe someone's microphone is on. We need to mute that.
Okay, sir, the question is related to, yes, sir, we can hear you, sir.
So maybe actually what's going on here. So sporadic research is going on. So when you want to get the maximum benefit, government promotion and the industries must come forward. So we have seen industries forward to help the scientists to develop this marine biotechnology. All some researchers, few very handful researchers actually doing this marine biotechnology research. So I think to get the maximum benefit, so government, big companies, they must come forward and then they should work together with the universities or research institute to develop or to utilize marine biotechnology in Bangladesh. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your nice reply. Another question is from Kashafat bin Hafiz. Hafiz, are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
Yeah, please ask your question directly to
sir. Assalamu alaikum, Sanjay Najar, sir. So my question was about seaweed. Sir, if there is any possibility that we can culture the seaweed along with the bioflock or aquaponics in Bangladesh?
I think we can culture the seaweed. One of our prominent researcher in our university, Dr. Mustafizur Rahman, actually, he has some projects regarding this. And if the effort is coordinated, I think we can culture. And sporadically, as I mentioned, some of the farmers, local farmers, are cultivating seaweeds, but not that much actually profitable, or they could sell, or they could gain something from that. But you know, you should involve the scientists, like Dr. Mustafa is here, or some other scientists. We has technical know-hows about how to culture, cultivate, isolate, preserve the seaweeds. Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Also, there is a question about the consumability of the seaweed that has been cultured, because mm-hmm. many of the seaweeds are not cultured in a good condition. They are so polluted mm-hmm. in many ways.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
That could be another problem.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you, Nafi, for your nice question. We have seen some more questions. One question is from Mr. Tapush Kumar Pal. Mr. Pal, are you there? Mr. Tapush Kumar Pal? Okay, the question is, sir, as you said, a teaspoon of seawater has more biodiversity than hectares of land area. How pollution can affect on that diversity and humans as well? This is the question from the Mr. Tapush. Sir, can you hear us?
I missed that because you were garbling.
Okay.
It was
okay. Okay. So the question is related to, as you mentioned, a teaspoon of seawater has more diversity than hectares of land area. So how pollution can affect on that diversity and humans as well?
Of course, the impact will be huge. So, you know, nothing is created or nothing is here without a purpose. So why this 70% of this whole world is water? There should be some reason. So the reason is, everything, all animals, everything evolved from the sea, as you know. Then we started crawling on this soil. So the biodiversity, of course, enormous in the sea, and biodiversity is huge. But the pollution nowadays, so many ships and we are exploring the seabeds for gas hydrates, some for oil, some other. So we are destroying the habitats. You know, the Great Barrier Reef in Australia, that was a coral reef, the largest coral reef in the world. That is also being destroyed because of pollution. The pH, the salinity of seawater, it also has some meaning. If there is a drastic change or little change of pH of seawater or the saline content of the seawater, change just little bit percentage, everything will be destroyed. And you know, we say Amazon forest is the lung of this earth. They provide oxygen, everything, but it's not true. It's the sea, the ocean, the chlorophytes, they provide oxygen for us. And with that oxygen, we are surviving. So you can imagine what will happen if this microorganisms, this biodiversity is being destroyed by pollution. Obviously, it will have a huge impact on the population and human being or every living organisms crawling on this earth. And it will be catastrophic, I must say. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your nice reply. Due to shortage of time, we will take one or two more questions. And first, the opportunity goes to Rashidul Islam Asif. Are you there, Mr. Asif? Mr. Asif, question is related to research. Is there any research production of biofuel from marine algae in Bangladesh? Is there any future of it?
Yeah, we have actually much potential to develop biofuels from marine algae. So as I'm repeatedly saying that we need coordinated effort, not just a pilot project or something like that. So some researchers actually working on it, but you know, we need fund, we need expertise, as I mentioned earlier. These are the common problems doing research in Bangladesh, especially this biofuel also. We have huge potential, but we don't know the technological know-how, and also we don't have money. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your nice reply. Our last opportunity goes to Nusrat Jahan Imu. Imu, please, ask your question. Nusrat Jahan Imu, are you there? Yes. Yeah, please unmute and ask your question. Maybe some technical issue. The question is, what is the effect of marine biotechnology in sustainable fisheries management?
Of course, it has a huge impact, I must say. In my slide, I mentioned that Canada, they are culturing salmon, they are culturing shrimp. France, they are culturing mollusk, sea cucumber, everything. So in Bangladesh, varietal improvement, or we can say for fishes, species improvement, high yielding variety, for that you need marine biotechnology. Already some farms are there, they are and they are doing good research. I must say our fisheries and livestock department, they are also doing good research. Even for Hilsha, you know, the genome sequence already has been deciphered, and barcoding out several fish species already done. So it's going on, and Agricultural University and some other universities are doing great work. So we have huge potential, and obviously in this sector, actually we are moving far better than other countries in the world. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. We are almost end of the session. It is really one of the nice event. We are lucky that our guest of honor, Professor Dr. Gulshana Lothia, madam, with us. Madam, it is a great privilege and great pleasure for NOAMI. You are with us, and we get inspiration. This is actually Women Leadership in Marine Technology related program. As I mentioned earlier, 14 September 2021, it means just 2 days later, one endorsed UN Ocean endorsed event will be occurred, organized by Marine Technology Indian section in collaboration with the NOAMI and some other organizations. So from NOAMI, I would like to request all of you to attend the event. All the links are given here, or you have any question, you just directly email to us. Now I would like to request today's session guest of honor, Professor Dr. Gulshana Lothia, madam, to say a few inspiration word for all of us. Madam, please.
Thank you, moderator, Dr. Mohan Kumar Das. It is a very nice to say that the NOAMI is organizing a beautiful webinar seminar on ocean science, marine biotechnology focusing on, and especially Bangladesh perspective. And our today's keynote speaker, Professor Dr. Muhammad Nazir Hussain. I couldn't listen all, please forgive me, due to I was busy with the defense of Stanford University Environmental Science Department. Still, the defense is going on, so forgive me, everyone. A lot of guests and others, members and from foreigners came here. And it was a beautiful presentation, because I just heard about the last that crustaceans and others and livestock, how much important agriculture, no field is left, that where biotechnological work is not going on. Biotechnology, technology based on biological system. And we know that it is a tropical country, and our the land as, Dr. Muhammad Nazir Hussain said, that land mass is very little in comparison to the ocean mass. So in the vast ocean, we have vast plenty of animal and plant bioresources, and that resources we can use it by technical way, biotechnological way, by genetic engineering, and then we used for the human welfare and also for other purposes. And because ocean is, sorry. Ocean is filled up plants, animals, and microbes. And for long time, we were using the conventional methods, but maybe 15 or 20 years, it is the biological science age and also the golden age for the biotechnology. And a lot of researchers and scientists are working in this field throughout Bangladesh. And it is the Prime Minister's dream, and also our father of the nation, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, that this country will be one day we can use the genome sequence, we can use the modern biotechnology to grow, to feed all the huge numbers of peoples of this country, because we have a less land mass. but our population is growing at geometric rate. Nowhere that we are using the technology, it helps everywhere, controlling pest diseases, and then from genetic resistance, through genetic resistance and improved diagnostics, and new vaccines by control agents, and also they are we can using the tools for food security and poverty elevation. So as I have said that we are using this technology in culture, aquaculture, in fisheries, not only fishes, but also fish related other animals in the marine environment. So Minister of Fisheries and Livestock have a scope for marine biotechnology elucidation and research sectors, a scope for developing these sectors more so that more researchers will come in this field, and many works will be going on. We know the global scenario that are based on products making biotechnology, insulin, we know for the human, and blood factor three, ACG hormone, and hepatitis, 13 vaccines, all are now producing by the tissue plasmogenesis activator based for, and also for heart attack patients, the tissue plasmogenesis activator we are using. We know that there are a lot of different types of algae, and it is full of vitamin A and other things. I don't go in the sectors as already mentioned. I'm a fishery specialist especially, but I go for now environment, and starting from the polluted environment, we know how much it is polluted already, the oceans by plastic. And we know there are some plastic eating bacteria. So we hope that in future, people will come ahead and they can, in marine also medium, there are a lot of plastic eating bacteria there. So they can help little bit by eating the plastics, as the land, there are some already work done by Oxford scientist and also Leeds University. So I, as already our keynote speaker has said that I couldn't listen all, but I can, if I have a note or other things, it will be nicer. Starting from welfare of the medicine, the plant improvement, animal health development, fermentation, environmental protection, waste management, all fields the work is going on. And also in the case of transgenic crops, cultivation in agricultural products and crops, livestock, fishing, forestry, everywhere. So our keynote speaker very nicely has said all these things. I think our young researchers will come this field and they can make it more successful, and they can develop some more points so that one day we will see that huge works has been done on this field, and the Bangladesh will be in a good position biotechnological work. So I congratulate everybody, and especially the NOAMI's members, directors, and Mohan, and also I'm not telling everybody's name, Muhammad Muslim, Sanjana, everybody, Naila, and Nusrat, and especially Mohan. So I congratulate everybody, and I think it is a great success, a webinar talk on biotechnology, learn a lot. So I pray that, and also tell the government should come forward in this field. They will give money, because without money, no research work can go on. And this type of work, if you want to do, if you need a big settled lab so that you can work. And recently, every corner of Bangladesh, this biotechnology has developed. especially we can see in Bangla, me, when I got a project from HACCP, and I also set up a DNA barcoding lab in geology department, Dhaka University, and Professor Sogir, Professor Nasser, Professor Shamimul Alam, Professor Reza Mohammad Shahjahan, Professor Mijan, and they are also working on this field, especially on the fisheries, algae, and other fields. And also Hilsha, as you said, Muhammad Najib, this scenario has completely changed. In human beings, there is XY genes remain in sex chromosome in male, but in Hilsha fisheries, it is in female. So we can see that due to applications of the genome sequence, we learned all these things. Thank you, Muhammad Nazir Hossain, Dr. Muhammad Nazir Hossain, and thank you, Mohan, and thank you, everybody. Good night, everybody.
Good night, madam. Assalamu alaikum, madam.
Waalaikum assalam. Acha, Mohan, amake jodi defense e abar ektu fire jete dao.
Acha, madam, amader program shesh, apnar speech diye shesh, shudhu amra board of thanks ta korbo. Thank you, madam.
Thank you very much. Ami shobar kache khoma chacchi.
Na, madam, apni achilen, shomoy dite perechen.
Thank you. Thank you.
Amra shobai khub khushi hoyechi.
Thank you, everybody. Bye.
Assalamu
alaikum, madam. Waalaikum assalam, everybody.
Thank you, madam. Okay, now it is really an amazing time for all of us. How marine technology will develop in developing country like Bangladesh. So now we have conducted one event. Hopefully in future we will try to organize more event. And NOAMI also doing lots of activity. In the introduction slide already Maliha mentioned. Now I'd like to request Maliha Malek to provide a vote of thanks, and if any urgent issue or any announcement, please. Maliha, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please.
Thank you all participants of today's program, and NOAMI is sending you greetings for participating here and making our program success. And I like to thank our keynote speaker, Dr. Muhammad Nazir Hossain, our guest of honor, for giving us a precious time in this busy schedule, and also our executive director, Mohan Kumar Das, and all the volunteers who make it possible for today's event success, especially Nafi, Nadim, Oishi, and Nafi, Rajak, Hassan, everyone. And inshallah, we will arrange more programs and training session on your demand. And please follow NOAMI in website or in Facebook. We are arranging lots of events, and I like to invite everyone to participate in the 14th September program, which is a global skill program. I request everyone to become the representative of Bangladesh in a global skill event, UN Ocean Endorsed event. And in chat box, we have given the registration link. Please follow it. And I hope we will have a great amount of participants from Bangladesh in a global event. Also, thank you again for participating to this program, and good night, everyone.
Thank you, Maliha. Thank you, Nazir sir, for your nice deliverable and to interact with the participants from various institute. Hope to see you again in various activities.
Arranging the seminar, I hope to join again. Thank you so much, and good night, everyone. Have a good sleep.
Thank you, sir. Good.